South Australians are being urged, though, to open their hearts to the asylum seekers bound for Inverbraggy. Now, refugees who call Adelaide home say they'll be forever grateful for the opportunities given to their families.
5 years ago, Asina Nozabonayu fled war-torn Burundi in Central Africa with just the clothes on her back.
Every night, whenever we are saying goodbye to friends, where we're going to bed, we say, you know, we don't know what if the next day we'll be alive.
For 10 years, she was in a refugee camp, living in constant fear.
It got to a point in a camp, it wasn't safe anymore. They were killing people. So once they come to your house, you are dead and they will take everything.
But in Adelaide, her family has started a new life.
Oh, well, I can't describe the feeling. I was over the moon.
I think I'm safe here.
In Australia, refugees like Asina and her family can gain an education, catch public transport and own their own home, freedoms that are simply unavailable in their birthplace.
Tariq Badan from Iraq knows all too well the oppression many refugees face.
The government, Saddam regime, hanged my brother, and I was really worried about myself and about my family.
Now he asks South Australians to sympathise with those bound for Inverbraggy.
These people have reason because they're looking for another life.
Lieutenant Governor and Vietnamese immigrant Hu Van Ly is confident South Australians will welcome the families.
This society is quite acceptance, and whatever will come, I think our communities will be able to handle it.
Hopefully giving their children a future others have been lucky to experience.
When I grow up, I want to be a nurse.
Sarah Arbo, 10 News.